Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a three-dimensional Rubik's Cube from scratch. This tutorial is in two parts. In part one, we'll create the template for the side of the cube and the basic cube shape, casting a shadow. In part two, we'll put it all together. Create a new document by pressing Ctrl N on Windows or Command N on a Mac. Name it whatever you'd like. Make its width 1550 pixels, its height 870 pixels, and its resolution 150 pixels per inch. The color mode is RGB and 8 bits per channel. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. We'll start by making a three-dimensional cube. It's important to note that 3D is only available in extended versions of CS5 and CS6, as well as all versions of CC. Versions prior to CS5 won't have 3D. Go to 3D, New Mesh from Layer, Mesh Preset, and Cube Wrap. If you see this message, click Yes. I did an in-depth tutorial on 3D, so if you'd like to watch it, I provided its link in my video's description. If you don't see the grid and the secondary view window, press Ctrl or Command H. In the 3D panel, click Cube Wrap. In the Properties panel, click the Coordinates icon. In the Y Rotation Angle field, type in 45. This rotates the cube 45 degrees on its Y axis. At the lower left corner, you'll see three black and white icons. By clicking and dragging each one, you'll be able to move the 3D camera around the cube. Click and drag the orbit icon straight down to orbit the camera to approximately this angle. Next, click and drag the pan icon up to pan your entire image up on your screen. Click the light bulb icon to open the lights panel. Earlier, I chose an infinite light source. However, if you don't have a light source chosen, go to the bottom of the panel, click the light bulb icon, and click New Infinite Light. Drag the handle of the light widget to an angle you like for the shadow. Click the infinite light icon. Make sure the color is white, the intensity is 90%, and the shadow is checked. Drag the softness to approximately 30%. Before we render the image, let's check your 3D settings. Go to Edit, Preferences, and 3D. There are two areas that are important, VRAM and Ray Tracer. VRAM is short for Video RAM. It's essentially the memory that's used for video adapters. I'm using all of my VRAM for Photoshop, however, it's really not necessary. Adobe states that the minimum for running 3D in Photoshop is 512 megabytes. The default setting of the threshold for Ray Tracer is 5, however, for this image, I'm using 4. The higher the number, the higher the quality will be, but the longer it will take to render. Conversely, the lower the number, the faster it will render, but the grainier your rendered image will look. Click the render icon and just sit back and be patient. It could take anywhere from a few minutes to over an hour to render it, depending on your particular computer's specs. Once it finishes rendering, the grid and secondary view will appear again. To hide them, press Ctrl or Command H. Let's view our workspace in the normal mode. To do this, go to Window and Workspace. Right now, 3D is checked. I already customized a workspace for myself. However, if you haven't done this for yourself, just click Essentials, which is Photoshop's default workspace. I'll click on my own workspace. Control-click or Command-click on the New Layer icon to make a new layer below the active layer. We'll fill the empty layer with white, but first, if your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Since white is the background color, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Flatten Image. When you see this message, click OK. Next, we'll create the side template for the Rubik's Cube. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Fill it with white and make another layer above it. Open your Rounded Rectangle tool and click your foreground color. In the Brightness field, type in 50 and click OK. Choose Pixels. If you're using CS5 or earlier, the Pixels icon is here. Make the radius 10 pixels. Click the gear icon and tick Square. Drag out a square approximately 1 inch and release. The square instantly fills with the foreground color. Double-click the top layer to open its layer style window. Click Stroke. Make the size 10 pixels. The position is outside and the color is black. Then click OK. We want to add a filter to the entire square, which includes the stroke. To do this, we first need to rasterize the stroke. Go to Layer, Rasterize, and Layer Style. Now, the stroke is fused with the square. As before, double-click the square to open its Layer Style window. This time, click Bevel and Emboss. The style is Inner Bevel, the technique is Chisel Hard, and the depth is 100%. The direction is up, and the size is 4 pixels. The highlight mode is screen, and the highlight opacity is 100%. The shadow mode is multiply, and its opacity is 50%. Then click OK. Let's collapse the effects to save space in the Layers panel. To do this, simply click the small arrowhead next to the FX icon. Make a copy of the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Press V on your keyboard to open your Move tool, and press and hold the Shift key as you drag the copy to the right. Holding Shift kept the square aligned horizontally as you dragged it across. We want the inside edges of both squares to touch each other. To do this, press the left arrow key on your keyboard to move the active square to the left 1 pixel at a time. Make another copy and repeat the steps. Merge the 3 squares into 1 layer by shift-clicking on the bottom square to highlight all the layers, and then pressing Ctrl or Command E. Make a copy of the layer, and press and hold Shift as you drag the copy straight down below the top row. Press the up arrow key to move it up until it touches the top row. Make another copy, and repeat the same steps. Merge the 3 rows into 1 layer. Drag it closer to the center if you need to. Next, we'll fill in the 4 white areas that show through the squares. Control-click or Command-click on the New Layer icon to make a new layer below the active layer. Open your Pencil tool and Pencil Picker. Make the size 30 pixels and make sure the hardness and opacity are both 100%. Draw over the white areas to fill them in. Merge these two layers by shift-clicking on the top layer and pressing Ctrl or Command E. In Part 2, we'll assemble our elements into our finished Rubik's Cube. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching!